de Naruto.
Thank you for that clap.
Just wondering whether there'll be one at the end. But I'd like to just inform the coordinator of this event is I'm getting quite hydrated. I'm in a bit of a bind here as to whether I should conduct this, what I'm going to be talking about, in English or in Maori. I want everyone to be part of this, but I don't want to leave anybody out. So what I'll do, maybe I'll speak some of it in Maori and some in English. And if I can manage a little bit of Espanol. Buenas tardes, señor, señores. Me timata pere nei kōrero. I runga i te mana i te ata nei, pātai ake au, timata mai, te ne mea te tikanga Māori, te kaupapa Māori. Nā, o ka takotori ake e au e nei kōrero mai te wāhi ngaro te wāhi, huna te kū tere tere maku a te kore. E pito pito kōrero noiho ene, e timata. E ngari he nui ngā kōrero ora. And so, as the beginning of kaupapa Māori, it must go back to the wakapapa, o te timatanga. And that's what I was referring to, the hidden spaces, the long-distance spaces. And the space of interaction. And there's a later development. Pupuke te iri, pupuke te maara, pupuke te wānanga, wānanga nui a te kore. And so this is another body of knowledge that our people talk about. Pupuke te iri, energy in space, abundant energy. Pupuke te maara, and there is the reference to memory. Pupuke te wānanga, and burgeoning of knowledge. And these are elements as part of a life principle. Wānanga nui a te kore. And so we go back to that kore concept once again. Wānanga nui a te kore. And I would like to say that kai roto katoa e nei kōrero i tēnā iwi, tēnā iwi, tēnā iwi, e nei kōrero. Engari kua tae pēr te wā, te wakāra hia mai e nei kōrero. A i roto tonu i a koutou anō, i roto tonu i a mātou anō. Nā te mea, ka kore pērātia, e kore tāia te waka ono ono ki ngā kōrero. Ka kōrero tia, i roto i a tātou, i roto i te reo Māori, i rongu au e te kōrero i te atane. A tā hua ngā kōrero, a tā hua ngā mai e mai a mai ana, a tā hua te hiki ake i te wairua tangata, te Māori tangata, ki runga i ngā koutou. So I see importance here in being able to get the knowledge out of that body of knowledge, because I believe it's as relevant today as it was 1,000 years ago. And so we need to look for ways of bringing those two bodies of knowledge together. Because as I said earlier, if we talk about it in Māori, it has a different focus, it has a different emphasis, and it has a different means of connection into the spiritual world and the physical world, because we're talking about the natural laws of the universe. And so we go from there tu ho tupu ho wara ora ki te waka tupua ora ki te waka tawe. And so there's the beginning of life itself, life principle. Te ora, the ability, the potential for life. It's being talked about in this body of knowledge. And at a later level comes to Rangian Papa. Our old people talked about te rā te wā, kaore he rangi, kaore he oenua, a te mea, e kū tere tere ana te ao. There's no rangi, no papa, because the world was in a continuum of the Western world refers to it as chaos. Māori is different. It was not chaos. It was a woven pattern of cyclic interaction. How's that? Oh, no. So it was not chaos, because when there's an explosion of energy, it's part of a process, it's part of a cycle. And once the explosion has borne itself out, it stabilizes once again. And so there's balance, there's equilibrium that is part of that dynamic. And therefore, marama tuturana o tātou kuia, tātou tau eke ki ene yahuata. And so from there, we come to Rangian Papa, ngā kaputa ngā tamariki a rangi, rāua ko papa. Nē ngā kōrero, korongo tau tangata matua te ngā tuatai. And then there were all the others. Tāne, tangaroa, tūmatau e ngā haumi a tike tike tā ri mātea. Then of course, can we include in here, hene ahuone? Because it's part of the dynamics of life itself. And so it goes on and on. But I think the important thing about this is that the interaction and the beginning and a recognition of natural universal law. Natural universal law. Koine ngā tua o te pō o te ao Māori. The beginning of natural universal law. And we need to recognize that it is still a valid focus for us today, because that natural universal law, from that comes the tapu nature of that natural universal law. Nā mai te tapu. Ka marama te titiro o tātou taumeke ki te taiao. Ki te tapu o ngā huatanga o te taiao. Nō reira, mehe mea ka ono atu tātou ki e nei a tuatanga. Tia tika tā tātou hua. And so, from that came, from the tapu came the concept of noa. And from there came the tikanga. In order to enter into the wāhi tapu, me arirunga i te tikanga. Engari ka aere i rupu i te tapu. Ka puta mai i te tapu. E aha te tikanga mo tēnei. What is the process of transition from the noa state to a tapu state? Well, I can imagine this house here. Te rā, i tomoki ai te ware nei. Ko aramai te iwi, i te tomo i te ware. E ai tomoki ai te ware, e tikanga. There is a principle and there's a protocol associated with the entering of the house and the sacred nature of the house and how that was done. And so it's observance of the principles of tika and pono. Be able to go from a state of noa to a state of tapu. Carry out the necessary interaction, not the mea, we were interacting with the natural laws of the universe. And so I leave that with you as part of my little contribution. E wakaroa ke mā koutou, mā tātou, that maybe there is something there that we can bring together and put together with what was presented this morning, what's going to be taking place this afternoon and tomorrow. And out of it, we can build a body of knowledge which is complementary with the traditional knowledge that is sitting out there in a little cupboard there, or in people's heads. I roto I ngā kōrero, I roto I ngā karakia, I roto I ngā waiata, e ia, e mahi ake mā tātou. So I would like to perhaps leave my little session at this point. And how much time have they got for questions? Sorry, questions later. Thank you for listening. And I will go ahead.